Hello students, welcome again in my YouTube channel Simple and Perfect Education Solution. Today I am giving you an important information about one task, that is social survey and problem eradication, which has to be done during second year D.El.Ed internship. It is for 5 marks, so it is very important. This video is specially for the students who are pursuing second year D.El.Ed student. It will be helpful how to collect information and write it report. So students, watch it carefully and watch it till the end of this video. So let's start without wasting time. First of all, I would like to tell you something about the objectives of this survey. For the purpose of survey, we have to visit the students' house, and before visiting the house, first of all we have to intimate the parent about your visit, and then only you can visit. So why we have to visit the house? Most of the times we find some problems of the student, and if you want to solve that kind of problems, then we have to visit the family, visit the house and know the problems, know the problems which the student has. So which kind of student has problems? Some students who are very weak in study. Most of the students we find are very shy, introvert. The student may be very naughty. The student may be late coming in school. Most of the times they may not be punctual. So all these are the problems which the student may have. And if you want to understand these problems, we have to visit the home and then collect the information. Then we can understand what kind of problem the student has, and then we can counsel the parents as well as we can counsel the student. For this purpose, we have to visit the house of the student and collect the information. For collecting information, I am providing you a simple format. With the help of this format, you can collect the information and you can write a report on that. First of all, you have to write the name of the student. In second row, you have to write the father's name. In third row, mother's name. Fourth row, address. Then on fifth, father's occupation as well as educational qualification. Then on the sixth row, you can write mother's occupation as well as educational qualification. Then number of brothers. After that, we have to write the number of sisters, and we have to write the educational qualification of both. So here we have to write the educational qualification. If we know the educational qualification of the parents, then we can understand what kind of environment do they have at their home. And ninth row, we have to write the economic status. Why we have to write the economic status? Because the financial condition of the family can affect the study of the student. If the rich parents are there, they can provide all the facilities to the student, and the student could able to pursue good education. If the family is poor, they could not able to provide all kind of facilities, so the student could not able to pursue proper education. So it is very important to know the economic status. Then next, number of earning members we have to write. Parents' opinion about their wards, again it is very important. Whether they have positive attitude towards giving education or not, that is very important. Or whether they have the negative attitude towards their wards, which is the student who is pursuing education. So opinion is very important. On 12th row, you can write the educational facilities the student are enjoying. It is very important to mention, because just now I told you while explaining the economic status, that is the same. 13th number, educational guidance. Whether the student is getting proper guidance, positive guidance from the home or not, that also affects on the study of the student. If they are getting proper guidance from home, they could able to pursue the education properly, as well as they could able to be on a right track of education. Then 14th, liking of learning. The student should like learning. It is very important. If the student like to learn, he could able to pursue education properly. He could able to take interest in learning. And when he will take interest in learning, he could able to do best in learning or education. On 15th point is that your opinion. Your opinion means here we have to write the opinion about the student. It may be positive, it may be negative. So we have to observe the student properly and we have to write the opinion, proper opinion, so that the student could able to do best in education. So this is the very simple format of collecting information. With the help of this format, you can write a report. Now next we will see, that is, in the beginning you can write this information: name of the student, school name, standard, division, address and contact number. So with this information you can write, you can collect and write a report on social survey and problem solution. So this is enough for today. If you find this information useful to you, then like it, comment it, subscribe it and press the bell icon so that you get regular notifications and updates. If you have any query about any D.El.Ed subjects or any doubt about the D.El.Ed subjects, then mention it in comment box so that I will try to solve your problems. Thank you. Be connected.